On the broadcast, let me quickly flip back in and rope in Mr. Suman Sinha on this. Mr. Suman Sinha, you know, is this something that you are feeling satisfied with? As the minister has just told us, there is something called strategic continuity, even if this is not big bang, or, you know, could we have used the opportunity to do more?
The FM has already done quite a bit in this budget. You know, she's let the fiscal deficit go to 6.8% for next year. They've already done quite a lot in terms of the mini budgets over the course of last year, which has led to a fiscal deficit of 9.5% for last year. So I don't think there could have been anything more done on the spending side. As far as you know, that is concerned, the government is already doing a lot. The question only is, how could that money have been spent? Is it being spent wisely? And if you ask me, honestly speaking, I think it is, because the government has taken a very clear view that rather than just put money into people's pockets and make them feel good, it is better to build the long-term productive capacity of the economy by building infrastructure in a number of different areas. Of course, doing so also creates jobs. It is also good for the economy in the long run, also does provide a booster shot. May take a, you know, several months longer for that to happen, but in the long run, it is much more sustainable and also is more productive. And so I think from that standpoint, the government has actually made the right strategic choices on how they wanted to grow the economy. And I for one, am quite satisfied with that. Now, as far as the capital raising side for the government is concerned, you know, a lot of people are carping about it and saying, look, will the government be able to sell so many assets, 1,75,000 crores? Are they selling a lot of other assets? And frankly speaking, my view on that is, it's good that they're doing it, because apart from the fact that the government is able to raise money by selling assets, it's also good for the government, like any other to recycle assets.
Okay, and to inject assets, them into the economy. But you know, but in a very real sense, Mrs. Minister, are you seeing in the sector that you're involved in, where we are being told what our power capacity is, we are heading into a zone where we are more than comfortable, surplus, and probably become an exporting nation in power too. DISCOM competition, more than one DISCOM, is an experiment that the budget wants to try out. It happens in other countries. And a logic of something to feel excited about. Do you go home tonight and feel, you know, a bit charged up? You know, the government is with us and not against us.
Well, the good news is that these days one works from home, so one doesn't have to go.
So already home. All right, fair enough.
So, but that's on a lighter note. No, look, I think as a business person operating in a certain sector, I have no reason to feel dissatisfied. The government has certainly announced a number of things. There is the issue of setting up the development financial institution, which is meant to do almost 5,00,000 crores of lending in the next 3 years' time. It's being well capitalized. You know, there's an issue about reforming the distribution entities by coming out of the 3.05 lakh crore scheme to improve their efficiency and their performance. There is also capitalization of the Solar Energy Corporation of India and IREDA, which is one of the lending agencies to our sector. So there's quite a bit that the government has done for our sector that I think is going to be good in the long run. And so therefore, and the last thing, of course, is the issue of choice and the distribution utilities, which will take time to get done. But I think the government certainly has embarked on that path, and therefore a few years down the road, I'm hopeful that it will happen, and that will be good for all consumers as well as good for the sector in terms of making it more efficient. So I think all in all, we're moving from being a slightly antiquated, old style, traditional sector, hopefully to becoming one that is more modern, that has more investment.
Okay, I'm going to ask you a very practical question before I get Mr. Satpathy into this conversation and then, you know, rope in Mr. Agarwal and Mr. Bhatti as well. Are you guys seeing, even if it's not statistical, anecdotal evidence between what you're doing in your firms, as well as people you're associating with? Is the cost of capital in India coming down? Have people actually benefited from these moratoriums, or were they just in theory on paper? And if they have, what is that model for 2021 now? Do we still need more of that, or good enough?
So let me start first. I think for me, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. So I can relate our experience on how the sector is performing overall. And as we all know, in the last few months,